Good morning, everyone. I'm Sweet Money, and welcome back to Airport CEO. Last time, we finished smoothing out some rough edges and opened up two additional large stands. Today, I think we're going to be tackling some more smaller refinements and expansions to help us cover all the new passengers flowing through our doors. Let's see what we can do. So research is usually the first thing that we take a look at, but we're just still researching the last research that we have left to do. So we're just going to let that keep going. And here's something we can tackle right off the bat. We got a very crowded bathroom right here. I think the fact that there's a elevator right outside of the bathroom is probably assisting in that. So where can we put another bathroom? Maybe down here? Not a whole lot of space down here. Although we could probably stick one on the corner over here. You know, let's do that. Let's stick a bathroom about right there. And maybe we can stick a smaller one right here. I don't hate that. I want it to be huge, but then I don't want it to also be overrun like the one upstairs. I guess we're just giving them some more options. So you know what? Let's adjust this. I'm okay with going all the way up to this side here. Actually, let's draw the walls first. So if we go like that, maybe like that. Yeah, what about something like that? Throw a couple of doors over here. Maybe one door. Not going to be huge, but hopefully some people will stop here instead. The problem is going to be if the AI is just really, you know, not super bright. Because this, we cannot fit very much else in here. I think that's about all that we can actually squeeze in here. So we're going to do that. And then we'll go downstairs. Let's speed up so these things get built. And we'll go downstairs and we'll build another bathroom right here, which will be much larger, and you know, everybody who's waiting for their bags will probably be able to take a little bathroom break if they need it after their long flight. Perfect. Stick another one of those guys right there, and as soon as this gets finished, we open this up and there we go, and it's already packed. That's exactly what I didn't want. I can't tell if we alleviated this. I feel like loading the game sometimes, there's just like a big mess of people that kind of have to get stuff sorted out. This might be okay. Once we get this one built, I feel like we just have a ton of people down here and they'll probably enjoy a bathroom. So this is kind of what I have planned for today. I think we're getting close to winding down our Airport CEO series, at least this one. One thing that I did want to tackle that I don't think we're going to be able to get around to is multiple terminals. Like the actual multiple terminals where I can create an area that's specific for a terminal. The problem with doing that is that you pretty much have to redo how our entire airport is working. Because the way they work is, I think it's an all or nothing approach, kind of like baggage. And correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. Maybe I'm misjudging this. I tested it for just a minute. And the way I saw it is that just like baggage, it's an all or nothing. But once you create a terminal, you need to have like pretty much the entire functioning airport and all of its amenities in that one section, which would mean we would need to create separate areas for check-in. Not impossible. I mean, we do have this here. If we're going to do that, which maybe next episode, if I do intend to do that, maybe we can make another episode out of it. We could make another check-in terminal over here, leave this one as check-in for terminal A, and we kind of always had this set up to be another entrance if we needed it to be. So then the only problem is going to be fitting like all the amenities for each stand, which we've kind of have everything separated already. I don't know, maybe it's something that we can do. I will look into it, and perhaps next episode we'll see if we can't separate this thing into three easier to digest terminals instead of one massive, you know, check-in at the front desk and then travel an hour and a half down there on this hallway to get to your flight. It might be able to work out. I was hoping it was a much easier process, but as soon as I started drawing out terminals, I realized, oh, we have a lot of work we have to do if we want that to work. So we'll just go with creating some refinements here just to make people's lives a little easier. And well, this bathroom is definitely in a lot better shape now. Let's go ahead and open up this one and see if people use it. And a lot of people are waiting for what I assume is a long time for their baggage here. They might need to use the bathroom, which or nobody, or absolutely nobody needs to use the bathroom. Either or. All right. Whatever. We got a bathroom for the homeless, if nothing else. Hey, what do we got? We got $1.6 million. I don't know how much this is going to cost. Let's try it, though. Build planned objects. $1.2 million. All right, let's do it. Let's finally build our second terminal here. I guess we could take a look at our finances while that's building. We got a daily. Oh, yeah, there it is. Based on our 12-day average, which I think the last couple days have buffed up quite a bit. $777,000 we made yesterday. So I think we'll be able to cover the cost of this expansion pretty quickly. All right, looks like we have some flight problems. Ooh, okay. This is actually something that these flights can't land because B1's occupied, and B1's occupied because catering is not happening. Is that 15 hours that it's been waiting? I think it is. It definitely is. 1240 was their flight. It's 4:40. 4:30 in the evening, and then all of these guys are being delayed because of it. What is happening here? Well, for one thing, can we just leave without catering? And then we'll figure that out. Dismiss aircraft. Will that just, like, get it to go? Okay. Yeah, we already got one queued up to land right here. Only 11 hours late for this one. Fantastic. Oh, boy. I think another thing that we might want to tackle today, maybe adding some more Terminal B stands. We got all this space over here. How much do those cost? Let's check it out. I'm talking about trying to handle extra people that we're getting, and then I go ahead and just want to add more. Stand. We actually have to get rid of a lot of this stuff first. Did I just go all the way down to the end here? I don't know what else we're going to cram in here. That's a future problem. That's a future me problem. Holy crap. Look at this mess of people in our self-check-in. Oh, boy. Oh, B1 is kind of caught up. I think we caught up with B1. We only have one more flight that is late. I don't know if the rest of B1 is still waiting on catering. I wonder if we just need more cars. We need more catering cars. What do we got here? Airside. Catering truck. We got two jobs claimed. I guess in like a perfect scenario, we might not have enough. Oh, there we go. Speaking of, we have three extra jobs available for catering trucks, and our cleaning trucks are also... Okay, let's do that really quick. Aircraft catering. Let's get another 6. We'll even it out to 10. I mean, they got to get to each stand. If we have a situation where like all of our aircraft are coming in and leaving around the same time, that could cause some delays. And then we'll do the same thing with the cleaning truck. We'll just get 6 of them. If we need to, we'll go ahead and build another actual building, probably over on this end because our other one's pretty far from here, but I don't think they should have a problem getting this far. Catering truck. Yeah, now we're short 5. Well, I think that was the problem. But for 15 hours, we couldn't get a catering truck out here? That seems ridiculous. Okay, so this one is only 2 hours late. What's B1 doing right now? Just landed. No catering service. I wonder if they can't get catering service over there. No, B2 is getting catering service, so that should be fine. I don't know. Might have just been a fluke. I'm sure I'm missing something, but we kind of straightened it out just by sending it on its way without food. We'll give them like a $5 coupon later, I'm sure. What are these guys complaining about? I saw you. No food. That is correct. We don't have any food establishments over here. Should I try for some like really small food areas over here? Maybe? Yeah, let's do it. Let's just get some pretty small, like seriously something like this. See if we have enough contracts that can... Oh, yeah. See, we can... Cranes, burgers, Hilltop, pretty much 1 and 2 star foods, but Bell Beer will even fit here. We can take another stab at Bell Beer. I kind of want to. Let's do it. Bell Beer, this is for you, buddy. All right, we'll do some hedges here. I'm going to say some food counters along the side here. I don't think anybody can actually get into that corner seat, but... We'll put it there anyway. And we need, what, 4 displays? And that's it. 4 display fridges and a cafe counter. Oh, the small one is pretty easy to fit here. So there's the fridges. And what Bell Beer is complete without beer? That fits nice and squeaky clean right there. Bell Beer check mark. Let's go. Jason's target was met 2. It just randomly picks how many days it wants me to succeed here. Oh, we got an employee here. Just got to finish building it. Let's extend that out one more. I like that. Oh, we're almost done. Looks great. Oh, somebody's sitting here. I don't know if they're actually eating. Well, I guess they are. We got 8 sales already. Hot damn. There we go. Okay, let's throw another one down over here. We're going to go overboard now. I know. You know, we get one little bit of success, and we're going to be all anxious to repeat that. All right, again, I don't think we can do anything over like 2 stars. Hilltop Cafe, but can we get a 2-star? I'm hoping we can at least get a 2-star. This burger sounds pretty good, though. Swift Veg. Let's do that one. Another 4 display fridges and a counter should do it. All right. So, like, practically the same layout, I think. That's super exciting, I know, but it's easy to do. We got hungry people. Play fridges. Nice little thing right there. Another small countertop right here. Maybe we can make this a little bit more quaint. Like, another round table right in the middle there. Looks gorgeous. Sign Swift Veg. There we go. Now, in the beginning, you know, when all of our restaurants were failing, the idea was to make a bunch of money on our restaurants. Right now, I've been seeing a lot of people complaining about needing food. So this is kind of just for our passengers right now. And I think Swift Veg gets a green carpet for sure. All right, there we go. Since we know how well little shops work, let's just put like 2 right here. And again, instead of walls, we'll do more of like a hedgy thing just to make it kind of pretty. Kind of one of those multi shops where you can't even tell tell where one shop ends and one shop begins. I like those. I know those exist, right? Okay, I think we can go. Is there only one shop counter? There's not a small one? I can place this in the middle of two shops? It'll let me. I don't know how well that'll work. I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna break everything here. We finally got some things working again. I'm gonna break it right now. We'll put that right in the middle of two shops. They can fight over it. All right, something like that. Oh, I don't even know who can fit here. Nobody. What are we missing? Size? Is it size for everybody? Oh no, we can't even make these small shops. Well, there goes that. I think I just have to make this one big shop. It's not the end of the world. Just immediately starts saying, can't cross different zones. Oh, wait, are we not secure right here? Is this not all secure? Maybe something that we got rid of made this insecure. Usually when we destroy something like that countertop right there, that would do it. Yeah, there it is. It was still showing secure on the overlay, but this thing right here probably wasn't secure anymore. So now, what kind of stuff can we throw in here? We can do some more shelves on the wall. Flygo is it. We got Flygo. Come on in. I don't know if that's going to cover us for shopping needs. We probably want one over here too, but we'll keep an eye on it. This guy wants to shop. Go for it. Right behind you, buddy. Just opened up. All right. Shopping desire done and done. Let's go like that. So should we put one more shop up here? I almost feel like we could put a pretty large shop right in the middle here since we have so many people kind of coming through. This is going to fail miserably, but let's try it. What can we get? Can we get like jewelry? You know, you get off your plane. You're coming to see your honey, and you forgot a gift. Might as well stop at the jeweler's. All right, that's what we're going to aim for. We need 9 shelves and cashier's desk. That is not a problem for this size of an area. This is a huge jewelry shop I'm seeing. I think that should do it. Jeweler's sign. Oh, let's make it pretty in there. Almost forgot about our hedges and plants. Go a little abstract on this one. This is going to have the most foot traffic, I think, in the entire... I guess aside from anybody... This bathroom right here. Cover this in the worst looking fancy mat we can find. I think we went overboard. Man, I really would like to understand the requirements for these really big shops. It's the really big ones that appear to, they just fail. Nobody has stopped here. I'm not sure if they take into account like what kind of shop it is. Like, does the fact that it's a jewelry shop matter? Maybe it does, because I wouldn't imagine that jewelry is something you usually go to the airport to find. So perhaps that's the problem. I don't know. We'll repurpose that, maybe use a different shop and see if it helps. Or maybe it'll all of a sudden start working. Still nothing all day. Like, people literally walk through this shop and we haven't gotten a single sale. All right. Well, then, who did that? Maybe it's just too big. You know what? I'm going to test one more thing. What if I get rid of... If I get rid of this and I put another cashier stand? I'm trying to think of this from a game logic perspective. Maybe the shelving is too far from the cashier stands and they're not able to manage that. I don't know. Maybe a larger area needs more than one cashier's stand, because I have not tried that. We'll just put that one right there. We'll make sure this is all security zone. Got rid of something. Oh, we have somebody looking. Might be absolutely worthless, but I wanted to try it. All right, we're gonna do maybe a couple more things here. One of them, let's buy some more ramp agents. I was noticing this little trigger happening, and then we'll go check on our late flights again. That appears to be another problem. Ramp agent, you know, just hire the whole lot of you. I'm just gonna go through here really quick on our 16 pages worth of employees and just max train everybody. There's our CIO that's still... I want to fire him, but I don't think he does enough. I think we're getting him for a bargain. We're paying him like $6 an hour. We're paying them less than minimum wage to be an executive in our airport. I think I'm just going to accept that. All right, everybody's trained up. As you can see, we are back up to $1.7 million. We made a little bit less of a profit yesterday than we made with that $1.7 million. I'm not sure why, but it's okay. We're still making plenty of money. We made back all the money on getting this runway up and running. So let's go ahead and say this is going to be arrival only, and this will be departure only. You guys might need a second to kind of refresh. Oh, we need to turn that on as well. There we go. That should be all we need to do for this. We kind of nailed ourselves into a corner here as far as de-icing is concerned. We don't have a lot of spots to de-ice, which is a little sad. Perhaps we can do something to alleviate that. I'm not sure what, without completely moving like everything over here, which is not impossible to do, but that would be a project. So I think that's all the time we have for today. Thanks for watching. Like I said, we're getting close to the end of this airport CEO series, but I'm probably going to try to get another episode or two out before moving on. If you like this video and the series, please do all the things. Leave a like and a comment and consider subscribing. It's a small thing, but it really does help me out a lot. If you'd like to hang out with me live, I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday on Twitch. I'll put a link below so you can follow me there. Thanks again for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll see you in the next one, but for now, please take it easy.